that was the spiritual condition before the Reformation. Cannot hear God's voice, not able to look, able to see beyond, only pray for sons and daughters, family well-beings and so on. If blind infant Christians before the Reformation. Today we will go over focusing on Reformation and relating topics in the area of Bible translation. Okay, here chapter 13, the blind infant Christians before Reformation. Now we are talking before Reformation. Before Reformation means majority Christians were under the Roman Catholics. No Protestant churches at the time. Of course, Orthodox churches. But majority in terms of Christian numbers, Roman Catholics. Of course, that church had major power over all Christians around the world. Now, before the Reformation, those Christians had their own Bibles. Okay? Now, that Bible, of course, that's original. Old Testament was written in Hebrew language. But make sure those days, Christians could not read Hebrew Bible. Okay, you have to make a note on that, okay? Christians could not read Hebrew Bible, only Jewish people. But at the time, no Jews were Christians. Now, in the New Testament, it was written in Greek language. Greek language. Okay. Now, it's this Greek language, New Testament, and also, I just put down here, Septuagint. Septuagint means use your own space, okay? This is important book here. Septuagint means it was written in near BC 200. BC 200, okay? At the time, BC 200 time, many Jewish people were dispersed as diasporas for many, many years. Diasporas. These Jewish descendants could not read Hebrew language, Old Testament Hebrew language, because they were they'd been dispersed all over the world. They have forgotten their old mother tongue. But they understood Greek language. So, in order to help them reading their own Old Testament book, 70 means it's that way. They say like that. That's a 70. It's a 50. 10, 10. Okay? 70 scholars gathered together in Alexandria. Where is Alexandria? Egypt. And translated Old Testament Hebrew language into Greek language. Okay, so at the time, so from that time on, from BC 200, Jewish people who knew Greek language could read Old Testament in Greek language, not NT here, in Greek language. 70 scholars. N? Oh, right, L. LXX, I'm sorry. LXX, 70 scholars. We call it Septuagint. Septuagint means 70. 70. However, at the time, this Bible was available before the Reformation. This Bible, Septuagint, was available, but no one could read. Only few scholars could read the Bible. Because of that, Roman Empire emperor asked scholar, especially his very famous scholar, Jerome. Under the leadership of Jerome, this Jerome translated Bible into Latin language, Old Testament and New Testament. It's a Latin language. This is old Italian language. Old Italian language. Old means at that time. Today's Italian language is a bit different from, they call it Latin language. So that Roman Empire people could read the Bible. Okay? So we call that Latin language Bible called Vulgate. Now, this Vulgate, although it was translated in Roman Empire language, Latin means Roman Empire language. Okay? Roman Vatican did not allow lay people to read the Bible. Lay people, laities, they could not even possess the Bible. In the event they possessed the Bible, they were under the punishment. This is a very important concept here. It was a Roman church's intention to make their laities blind, not to expose biblical teachings available to them. So naturally, those laities, congregations, did not know much about the Bible. It was their policy. Only those limited number of scholars could read the Bible for their own purpose, to dominate laities, lay people, to control them. Now, then how could those lay people understand Bible? Now, they just gave them, the church gave them just the key messages for them to follow their control. Okay? So now you can see in the Roman Catholic Church inside, you can see all kinds of pictures. Okay, you always find, even you Filipinos, you see, when you enter the church, you can see beginning of creation. You know, Genesis chapter 1 and 2 stories are pictured some over the right side, and then it goes around creation and creation of Adam and Eve, and all the way down there, and flood stories, and over there, birth of Jesus, and crucifixion of Jesus, and resurrection of Jesus, ascension of Jesus, and the last moment is a judgment story. Okay? Those main stories are pictured around the church wall. The Christian sitting there, just watching over those pictures. Oh, now we know what the Bible said. That was the maximum their understanding of the Bible. Even those, the bishops, only limited to their knowledge to those pictures. Okay? With an exception of scholars who read Latin Bible. Now, not only pictures, they emphasized on the worshiping Maria, treating Jesus as a baby. So you will notice in the church, picture of Maria and statues of Maria and baby Jesus, okay, sitting on her knee, lap. So whenever you visit Roman Catholic Church and seeing all kinds of pictures, oh, why? Then you have to go back to here. Blinding, purpose of blinding Christians. Exposing biblical teachings only through these visible pictures and statues. Okay? And also they developed saint worship. As a result, we see sculptures all over, saint sculptures. That was the only Bible teachings available, okay, in the church. As a result, what would happen? The Christians could not possess Bible. They were spiritually blind. You see, over here, no Bible knowledge at all. Christians, with an exception of those pictures. Even today, you see, in the Philippines, Roman Catholic Church are in domination. You know, average Roman Catholics on very lack of biblical knowledge. Now, no Bible knowledge, therefore, even leaders, even as a result, they all, including leaders, all spiritually blind. You will notice that majority Christians at that time, before the Reformation, okay, majority Christians near death spiritually. Near death. Majority Christians were sleeping. You know, Revelation chapter 3, church in Sardis. Jesus mentioned about their spiritual condition. You are about to death. Let you better wake up, and so on. So here, the same way here, this Roman church at that time, before the Reformation, near death, sleeping. Also, they were blindly obedient to the authority of Roman Catholic Church. It's a blind obedience. Otherwise, they will be under the penalty and persecution. Now, why blind infant Christians? I just raised up the question here. That's simple. No spiritual food fed. No spiritual food fed. So we are a spiritual being. We need not only physical food, but also spiritual food. Now, here, no spiritual food given to them. As a result, what will happen to them is spiritually malnutrition. Malnutrition, right here. You know the meaning malnutrition. Okay? So they, no spiritual growth as a result. No spiritual growth. I just itemized right here. In five senses, spiritual meaning five senses. Here, spiritual eyes. They're almost blind. Spiritual eyes. And not only they're blind, all kinds of spiritual eye diseases. Eye diseases, write it down, okay? I don't have any space, so you write it down. Spiritual eye disease, namely, you see, short distance, near sight disease. Write it down there, okay? Only near sight, only thinking of self and family, their physical health and money, not able to look, able to see beyond, only pray for sons and daughters, pray for family well-beings and so on. Physically, spiritually, their eyesight is a very short eyesight. You have seen many people like that. In spiritual, here, ears. Could not hear the message of God. They are very dumb. In a spiritual eyesight, you got all kinds of spiritual diseases. You know, distorted view. Would you write it down? Distorted view. And I say blind, even colored eyesight. A different color, you cannot identify a right color. Then, spiritually, one eye view, one eye. Now, ears, cannot hear God's voice. Many times, a hearing Satan's voice, cannot make distinction over God's voice and Satan's voice. And spiritual taste. You can't taste the goodness of our Lord Jesus. You cannot taste the Word of God. Losing that taste, insensitive to that taste. That's all diseases. Diseases in five senses. Okay? When you are lacking in spiritual food. And spiritual touching, feeling, no senses at all, sensitivity, spiritual sensitivity, lacking in spiritual sensitivity. When you are in malnutrition, also smell, spiritual smell. No discerning spirit, no discernment, gift of discernment. Not sensitive at all. Dull. Now, continue. Not only these five senses, also spiritual muscle, no strength. You cannot go out and evangelize. Okay? You cannot exercise, spiritual exercise. You are not active in church services. No spiritual muscle. And no spiritual bone. You cannot stand on your own. You always lean towards someone else. No spiritual bone. Very soft bone. And spiritual stomach, digestion. They cannot digest solid word of God. They always need spiritual milk. Milking. The Christians only can, you know, sucking milk bottle. And 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 1 and 3 said that you, Corinthian churches, you only can eat spiritual milk. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 1 and 3. You are spiritual infant. You know, only infants can sucking a milk bottle, not able to digesting solid food. Okay, in this, my lectures, I try to, although this is a solid, it's a difficult, hard topic, it is my job and your job to make it soft, okay, eatable, digestible food for them to understand and can digest. Now, here, before Reformation, because of what? Word of God was not available. Only limited to those so-called scholars. All laities, all Christians were under the malnutrition. That was the spiritual condition before the Reformation. That applies to even today's church. So now, here in lecture 13, blind infant Christians before Reformation. I just want to tell you at that time spiritual condition which led to Reformation. Okay? This spiritual condition eventually led those concerned leaders, Luther, Calvin, Zwingli, all other reformers, leading to Reformation. Spirit of God inspired them. It's a time to wake them up. That was the epic. That was God's right divine time for waking up Christians, which we call Reformation. Okay? So we will study more in detail on hidden inside of the Reformation today and next time as time goes on. Thank you, Lord, for this time together. May all of you be specially blessed by the Word of God. Amen? Yeah. Thank you.